So they are a private university as well. So they prefer English only.
Yes,
Like,
okay.
we belongs to different state. Like in Madhya Pradesh, there is a native Hindi. But if I go somewhere for interview, then they only required English, not Hindi. If I speak Hindi, then they think like, oh my God, she speak Hindi. She don't know English. How it's disgusting. Like this kind of thoughts. We are not changed like people's thinking, but yeah, this kind of thoughts in that mind. So in like our native is a different, but English is the most important language in the worldwide.
Okay. Thanks, thanks
Because
for.
I always
Let's give the chance to other participants. Yeah, you give in very good point. And so, yeah, there is Sanjeev. So please unmute yourself and speak about that topic if you are audible. If you are able to.
Yes, I am audible. Today topic is English, importance of English in our life. As we know, there is international demand of the English language, because I think more than 30% overall the world English is spoken people. So if we talk about the top countries like the USA and the South America or Australia or like India too, many European countries where the English are the very important for their daily life communication and daily life work also. So we need English highly demanded. So, and if we talk about the, what are the importance we have to gain a job, I think like many exams like IELTS, TOEFLs, these are the English best examinations in which we have to increase our vocals and written communication also, according to which they judge our communication personality, or based on that they also offer us job. So internationally, if we want to put our ideas, then their need of English language highly demanded. Thank you.
That's great. You explain everything very clearly, and let's give the chance to other. Yeah, very good explanation, and I was expecting this kind of explanation too from everyone. So let's talk. Who want to speak first? So if you want to, they speak. Unmute yourself and speak.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, Nitin.
I'm Nitin. Yeah, first of all, I'm in village. Here is celebrating Navratri. So the background sound is disturbing all of you.
Okay,
Today
no
I'm
issues,
not
nothing.
saying much, but I'm just trying. English is a, because you know all, English is a global language. So everyone understand and communicate easily in all over whole world. Today's English is very important because the internet languages is English, and the future upcoming, the era is a technology era. Everything is working based on AI, that is called artificial intelligence. The programming of AI is depend on Python language, and the Python language is working as like English language. So I think everyone should know about English because it's our future.
Okay.
And you will,
Yeah.
so you
Yeah.
will
Okay.
educate each other with English easily.
Wow, that's great. You add very good point. English is important language for internet. Now everything available in internet in English. Yeah, other language too, but English is more content. Even for the scientific paper are written in English only. So yeah, you come with a very good point, and yeah, really important point in this discussion. So let's give the chance to another person. So anybody want to talk? So please unmute yourself and talk. So let's pick someone. Pooja, please unmute yourself if you are able to hear me.
Hello everyone, good evening.
Good evening, Pooja.
So the topic is how important English language. So today in 21st century, the English is very important to learn any language. The English language help us to learn other language. If when we go for job, for interview, they take our interview in English, they ask a question in English. And when we search anything from it, we type in English. So every time we need to talk in English, learn in English. So English is a global language, and international also helps us to develop other languages. So English is most important language to develop.
Okay, that's great. You adding new point, like studying English can help you getting a job, something. So yeah, that's great. So let's give the some other participant to chance. Marjan.
Okay.
Yeah, here is one. Anyone is Marjan?
Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello. See.
So please introduce yourself and start discussion with the topic.
Yeah, I'm Marjan Kalamatia. I'm originally Iranian, but
your voice is not clear. Your voice is not clear.
I want to talk about benefits of language, English language.
Okay, let's give other person a chance. Actually, your voice is not clear.
Okay.
Okay, okay. I will come with you another time.
Sorry, your voice is not noisy.
Okay, you unmute yourself.
I don't.
And let's... come with any other participant. Hi Rani, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, please continue with the topic.
So
our topic,
same topic.
Yeah, you can continue because we all are new, so it's a very easy topic, so we can communicate each other. We want to just listen to another word, so we can get a good point.
Okay, so like now I want to share like my real example. You know, once like twice I went for interview, and there is like a interview before I thought experience is important. I should do job and gain some experience, then after I can get easily good job. But you know, like when I went for interview, there is I saw, you know, like there is a not experience that doesn't matter there.
Okay, yeah.
They only require English communication. You know, like front of my one guy, he's communication skills, it was excellent, and you know, like he got a good salary offer as well. He got a offer like offer later because of communication skills. So after that, I understand it's the most important language for everyone. That's the main reason I want to also improve myself.
Okay, that's good. And yeah, anybody more want to talk about this topic, please unmute. And and those who talked, please unmute yourself and give chance to others.
Hello, good evening, everybody. Hello.
Hello. Yeah, yeah. You are audible.
Hello.
Yes, you are
good
audible.
Good evening. Good evening.
Good evening.
I am Nizam from Bangladesh.
Wow, that's great.
Today topic is English is important.
Yes, yes.
Nowadays English is very important because when we go to medical doctor, doctor prescribe me in English, and when we go to visit for another country, everything is in English. Also, educational institution and means higher study is in English. That's why English is very important in our daily life. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, that's Very nice introduction, and you given very real example. It's very true that every prescription written in English only, and that's good point. Very interesting. And yeah, we have two topic: increasing population in the world, good or bad. So yeah, anybody want to talk earlier topic, importance of English language? So please unmute yourself and talk. Here is Sahil Misra. So if you are listening me, so please unmute and introduce yourself and talk about the topic. Okay.
Can you please repeat the topic? I have not heard.
Okay. I'm repeating the topic: importance of English language, and another topic is increasing population in the world, good or bad. So you can pick any one topic and you can continue.
English is a very important language nowadays, because in every field it is very essential to know English for any interview purpose or for anything.
Okay, that's good. Anything you want to add more? Yeah, any personal experience where?
Yeah, if we know English.
Okay.
If we know English, then we are able to know the other person or the thoughts of other person.
Yes.
Very well.
Very well. Yeah, that's good point. If you know the different English language, so we can connect with the multiple culture people. So it's also true, and we can meet new people very easily, and we can communicate with the different global level. And so, because English is a global language, so you added a very good point in this conversation, and hope you will continue this conversation till the last. Okay, so let's come with us. One participants. I think nothing is expect like Neha. Neha, please unmute yourself. If you are listening me, please unmute and add some point in this discussion.
Hello, Neha. Can you hear? Can you hear us, Neha?
Little bit. If you don't want to speak.
Is there anyone else?
Okay, let's come on the next topic. So let's see who will first unmute yourself and talk about the topic: increasing population in the world, good or bad.
Okay. Neha, do you want to speak? Hello, Neha.
I think there might be network issue. So guys, a very good evening.
Okay.
So I would like to talk about importance of English.
Okay, that's great.
So is my voice clear to everyone?
Yes, you are very very much audible.
Okay, that's great. So it will be very tough to complete all the informations to talk in details regarding this in a very short time. So I'm trying to give a speech in a very short time, or you know, I'll try to cover lots of things in a short time. So English is a global language. Obviously it is very very important for many sectors. In every sector it is important nowadays. In education sector it is very important, because if someone wants to go outside of, you know, the country or his or her country, then English is the most important language, most common language to communicate with that foreigner persons. And if we talk about traveling, then English helps us. This is a language which helps us to communicate with unknown persons, right? And for internet purpose, in internet world, if we search anything on the Google, then we will come up on new things with in English only, right? So yes, definitely it help us in internet to learning anything on internet, to read newspapers internet, to read any articles on internet. And for any kind of, you can say, like competitive exams, like I'm an aspirant of competitive exam, so I'm preparing. I know the importance in competitive exam. And I hope, guys, you almost, you know, this importance that each and every kind of competitive exams, English is required. Without English, no one can crack any kind of competitive exam, right? Whether, you know, your medium of the exam might be your mother tongue or vernacular, it doesn't matter. There should be a compulsory subject, right? So English is important in that point of view. And if someone, you know, to share our idea globally, if we want to share our ideology globally, then English become a, you know, common language. Otherwise, suppose my mother tongue is Bangla, so if I, you know, share my thoughts on the internet, right, globally, then from USA or UK, they cannot understand this. So English is important in point of that point of view. And if we talk about like earning online, nowadays lots of people are earning online because they know English. They are very very, you know, fluent in English, so they are making videos, uploading on YouTube. They're earning some of their, you know, many people, so they are, even in India, they are very good at English, and they are writing some things and uploading on the, you can say, Google. They're making websites, and through that they are you know, generating revenues. So this is one another point. If I talk about, like, you can say, making friends, right, foreigner friends, you can make friends also from outside of India. As I'm from India, so I'm saying outside of India, it means if wherever you are, it doesn't matter, out of your country you can make friends. It doesn't matter he knows your mother tongue or not, his mother tongue may be different, but English helps us in that point.
Okay,
and
that's great.
Yes.
Let's give the another person a chance. So there is Rajiv. So please unmute yourself and speak about the topic.
Thank you very much, guys.
Yes, you have done very good job. So Rajiv, are you there?
Me?
Rajiv. Okay, a little bit.
Yeah, that's great. Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah, Raju, come up with it.
I'm adding some point in this importance of English language as a global language.
Okay, Nitin, one minute. Raju want to talk, I think.
Yeah, okay.
He unmuted your...
Hello.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Raju.
English is the language of international communication.
Yes.
I think approximately 200 countries has in world, and approximately 53 countries are spoken official language as a English.
Wow,
so English is very
okay. Yeah.
English is very important for communication with another countries, with internationally as well as in own countries. Because every state has different language, and one language is united, like English. English have give good opportunity for job. Every interviewer ask in English because English is a official language. In every state and every country, every Indian state. So in approximately, it is a newly language which is very developed, because 400 million people speak English, and it is a second language after the common language for the every people. So it provides a good opportunity for job in different sector. I think it is very demandable. So everyone uses and want to know about English.
Yeah, you and come with a very good point that 50 countries approx in the world talking in only in English language. That is a global language. So yeah, that's a new point in this discussion. So I want to come with the second topic. So let's see how many people are will know about that topic. Increasing population in the world, good or bad? So who first want to talk on this topic? So please unmute yourself and give the chance other people, and let's see who will be coming first.
Yeah, hello.
Yes.
In my opinion, like, you know, increase the population, it's not good.
Okay.
Because if population is increased as well, you know, like, we can see there's all the things is very expensive. Like all the foods, fruits, and all the things because of increase the population. Before, like, we have a, you know, like, before there's a not too much economy, it's not good. But gradually our economy is a level up, but as well our economy is level up. But you know, there's a lots of generation, like new generation, because in the one family there, you know, like one couple, they have lots of children. We can see 2 children, 3, 4, 5 to 6. So it's not, you know, if yeah, in the one couple they must take only 2 babies or 1. It's enough for them. So if we are control like population, then we might be happy in our future.
Okay, but Rani, earlier the people are thinking that in family, if there is a huge children, then they will do the more earning in the future. So that's why they are increasing the population. So that's a true fact or just a false fact? What do you think?
But you know, it's still in like this generation, if there's a like 5 or 6 like children at home, maybe their parents are poor. Like, as we belong to normal family, so they are poor, so how can we survive?
Okay, so let's
the main thing, if they have a two, then they can
survive.
Let's give
the mic to the Sanjeev Kuswa. Let's see what idea he have, because I think he have much knowledge on the debt topic. So please unmute Sanjeev.
Thank you for such compliment. But I think I have but little knowledge. but I want to give a view clear or the clear picture of the population and what are the reason behind the increasing population day by day. If I start my discussion, just talking that the population are increasing, just not increasing, but if you go 2 or 3 decades back, then when there is a lack of knowledge, the people's, if I'm talking about the women's, in between the women's, there is a lack of educations, lots of the poverties, and lots of the resource lackness. That's a more give focus to cause the population increment. If the women are educated, then they never take the 2 or more or 5 or 6 children or babies. They oppose this to their husband and also with their families. But I think more genuine reason is behind that. If there is want of the boy, I think people are thinking that if they have only the girl, their generation will not go more and more time period up here. So in the want of boy, they take 2 or more children.
Yes.
And I think this is the one reason, and second reason is you talking also that I think there is a lack of knowledge.
Sanjeev.
Yes.
Okay. Would you mind if I interrupt you?
Yes, please.
Okay. I would like to ask a question. As you mentioned that it is because only lack of knowledge of women. Don't you think it is also lack of men as well? Or do you think it's only because of women? Do you think like that?
It's also the man. Man is, but I think women should more, because although they carry the more time, baby.
Okay.
Am I right?
No, you are right. You are right to
women have
some
to
extent, but
because women bears a boy, a child, 9 months. and they carry after the every 1 year or 2 years, then they suffer more. They should have the good knowledge about the why they do. If they should also think, am I able to?
Why they should think? If the men are capable enough, knowledgeable enough, then men should understand. Men should make her wife understand, right?
No.
It is not only because of women. It is because of men and women.
Every time why men stand up for their right. So women have to stand up for their right and everything. Because if they are suffering for the 9 months, every 1 or 2 years, so they have to stand for their life also. Because they are giving a new baby born, and so have to think about the future. How can I give the this thing?
Let me conclude my topic.
Sure.
I think if I conclude all the things of increasing populace, now if I am talking about the India, it carries the 135 crore population nowadays. India's population now saturated, I think. So the new policies, if the governments are making, that does not work, because our population is now at the level of this saturation. So if government start making the policy, then for the one baby or two baby, like China has done in the past, there is no rules in the China for the one baby, like in the same way the India does, then it will not good for us. I think India is at this time, India is now well educated, and if women are make to more educated, then the population increment is also decreased, and it comes at a situation level. And like I think every should have the one or the two babies, and its increment is more burden out our resources. As I have read last in the in a report, there is written that India's generation of the grain is less than we are eating more.
Yes. Uncontrollable.
Now India has the unbearable resources for our generation. Thank you.
Yeah. So this thing happened because uncontrollable urbanization is also, everybody want to become urban. So if every villager want to go to urban area, so crowded, city crime also increasing, and politics, so many things changing, crime is also happening, everybody want to shift in the urban area. So pollution also happening, so many things happening due to the pollution, population. So population causes so many things changing in our society. So I think if that is controlled manner, so we will got enough opportunity, job, as well as so many things. If you talk about India, for the population is not only depend on the person, it's also depend on the geographical condition. So in other country, population is not much due to the favorable of that, not much favorable of that climate. So yeah, but we can control in India. So this only happened after the education, proper education.
Now one new member has joined. So could you please introduce yourself?
Okay.
Hello, you are most welcome to this group. New member, just now joined.
Hello Daya, how are you? Please explain yourself and talk about the importance of English language. So we all are waiting for your some point in this discussion. Am I audible, Daya?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay.
So I think you have not done the topic importance of English. Have you spoken about that?
Yeah, earlier we did.
Hello. Sorry, I want to speak, but the background music is.
Okay, no problem. Just speak. Okay. No problem. Hi Nitendra, just continue.
Okay, I'm trying to search a place.
Okay.
So the world population is growing day by day. As you will say, as you said, the many problems has enhanced, like educationals and surviving, like food, clothes, shelters, and many other problems having. So I think the society, especially in India, I think the society will be educated, then the problem will be reduced.
Okay.
And the population is under control. So first of all, we have to, and also the government has to implement and to doing program to educate, to aware everyone about the populations. Then the population will be in control.
Yeah, yeah, that's good point.
Yeah.
Government can give the awareness in society.
Hi, learning studio. Can you hear us? Hi, you are most welcome to this group, learning studio. Can you hear? Please turn on your mic and respond.
Hello. Yes. Guy.
Okay. Learning studio. Very good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay. So, yes, could you please give your? Okay. So, could you please give your introduction? In short.
Yes. Yeah. My name is Amit Chauhan.
Wow.
And basically, I am from Neuron Informatics, and I'm working in server manufacturing company.
Okay. That's good. So you know what discussion is going on. So let me brief about that topic. Importance of English language and increasing population in world, good or bad. So pick up any topic and please continue on that topic.
Yeah, English is very important nowadays.
Yes, learning studio, please you talk something on the importance of.
I'm behalf of the learning studio.
Okay.
And for the today's topic, the importance of English language. Yes, I'm correct.
Yes. The second topic, increasing population in world, good or bad. So just now we are talking about
the increasing. I'm going to be the first one. Yeah. According to me, English is not important for all of us.
Okay.
Because it is only a language, and which is barricading all the knowledge of our generation and everything. English is just a communication method now, and for the India, it is only because of the English people who just occupied the India before the 1947. And as you see, the Europe, China, and Russia, and this is the best example of the unimportant of the English language, because they are the successful countries now without the English. Are you getting my point? As the inner China, as Europe don't follow the English language, and the Paris, they speak the French, Spanish, and the most speakable language is Spanish, and then the second one is French in the Europe, and as the same for the China, and they are the
counter argument to China is now. I don't agree with you that
sir.
English is not much important. I think it's a skill. If you have extra skill, then you will pay more. So why? What do you think is stopping you to learning new language? It's just a skill.
You point for the payable now for the English language. I just want to say that English is not the most payable language now. It is the French is the most payable and the most expensive country in the world is the France, and they don't follow the English culture. They follow their own culture, their own customs,
but,
their own rules.
If you go into the any interview, nobody asks in the French. In real, if you go to the ground level,
if you have the additional knowledge of the French and the Spanish, then you will get the maximum amount of salary.
I don't think so.
If you get an additional language as a French or Spanish, if you want to survive your career in the Europe.
Suppose that
so
if somebody wants
to
stay in India,
the English is not more is not important. English is necessary. It's not important.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, okay, got it. If you want to say that, that is not important, it's necessary.
Yeah.
So okay, learning studio. So what do you mean? How do you define a necessary and important?
What
I will define you necessary. And you eat the food, it is necessary. You eat a rice and a chapati in a food, it's a necessary. And if you eat a burger, pasta all the time, it is a just your choice. As the English is not the choice. If someone in my India, have you heard that the Mukesh Ambani is giving in
so okay, do you mean important and choice two are similar word? You are comparing these two. You are comparing these two, like you are eating food, this is a necessary, and you eat burger, this is a choice. So you are explaining about necessary and you know important. So are you
word is the important to use for the English is that the English is important. English mahatvapurna hai. The English is mahatvapurna and the important word is so heavy word, so we can't use. We can say the Hindi is the most important now because they English degrade the Hindi now.
No I think nobody, no language is degrading each other. Never conflict the language because English is
conflict.
English always connect
the people. Now 1 minute. Have you Gavin got a happy moment in your life and then you want to discuss with your parents? The first thing is you will say them in a Hindi, not in English.
Okay.
Your happiness, your sorrow, your every emotional point is come with the Hindi, not in English. If English is important, then your
because other languages too.
Okay, learning studio. I will, we will come to you.
Okay.
Now let others, throw their views on this same topic.
Sure.
Is anyone left with the topic importance of English?
I think.
Is there anyone?
Nijam is left.
Please, we are not able to see you properly. So if you think you have not spoken on importance on English, so please unmute your mic and please speak on this topic. Hello, is there anyone?
Okay, come with the second topic. So one person is only talking about that thing, increasing population in the world, good or bad. So anybody want to talk, please unmute yourself.
Here is Anger MD, right?
Yeah, he unmuted you.
Anger MD, can you hear?
Maybe some audio issue. Abhishek, leave it. Let's continue another topic because already the time is more than half hour is. So increasing population in the world, good or bad? So anybody want to discuss? Pooja?
Hello.
Okay. Yeah, Nijam.
Hello. I am Nijam from Bangladesh.
Okay. Nice. Please continue with the topic.
Next topic is increasing population is good or bad?
Yes.
Actually, it is a very controversial issue. Increasing population is good or bad.
So what's your perception?
My opinion, if the population is converted into manpower, then improvement is granted. Because in Bangladesh, in 1971, population was 7 crore, now is 18 crore. That time, that means 1971, GDP was around $18 billion. Now, $324 billion. That means we converted population into manpower. That's why I think population increasing population is good for nation. Okay, thank you.
It's really awesome point.
Oh yeah, that's good. So Rajiv, please unmute yourself and talk about the topic. Rajiv? Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, Rajiv, please come with the topic.
I think that increasing of population is bad.
Okay.
Because it provided unemployment. We know that our population of India increases. As growth, it came with unemployment. And unemployment makes as poor as everything. Like, I think that we can, it is a problem of family planning. Most developing nation has large number of people who are illiterate, like below the poverty line. Due to the causes of family problem, when the family members, like children, is not mature and it is forcibly married, then due to illiterate causes, many another new babies are born.
Okay.
And it came with many problems because unemployment are happened, and due to the coming there are more problems have happened.
Okay.
And I second thing in discussing like illiteracy of India. Now it is developing in India in literacy. Means education are now day by day increases. So I think that the population problem will be reduced. Like India, UP state in coming of two children in one family is more beneficial for our UP because population of UP increases. We know that the population is increases more than 25 crore in UP.
Yes.
In a single state. So for it causes and the employment of UP is very less. So most people are working as a labor.
Yes, yes. It's a fact that you people are working as a labor.
And labor never teach our children as a IIT or university college and another BTech college because there is not enough money in gate due to the labor. And thinking is also not increased. So I think that employment is more causes of population, and population can be necessary to reduce by literacy people and providing the knowledge about many causes of it causes many resource problems. We know that in India it is problem of water due to every resource are increases and money will be also increases.
Okay.
So I think that we follow the policy of government. Two children in one family.
Yeah. So nice conclusion that we have to follow the policy of the government, two children. And you come up with a very good point, and everything you mentioned very clearly that why is that increasing. So that's good.
Now travel with Divya. Daya, travel with Daya. Can you hear? Hi, travel. So have you spoken about this topic, increasing population?
No, I just joined this group, I don't know what the purpose of this group.
So, yes, yes, you speak something, increasing population on the topic.
I think it's neither good or bad, just okay. For my point of view.
So how we balance, like if we think that is very much, like we are becoming approach to the China populations, it's good? Are you thinking that is good?
I think even in China, got to know that in China there are so many cities, there are so many buildings and no one are living over there. So they are called Gao cities. So I think in China, so many you can say buildings are empty.
No, China is the most populated, you know, fast populated country in the world.
Think India should they take the step for the, because already population is a much. So we have to some education awareness, like in village, government can make some group, small group, and they give the awareness to the women's. Because women's, if not standard for their rights, then nobody can make awareness. So I think education only can make this thing.
Yes, education can make these things, and it is the awareness are being given nowadays in each and every corner of the India and around the world even, right? If you go to any hospital, you can see, you should plan your, you know?
Yes, sir.
Right? So, yes. So, Sahil, can you hear?
Nice there for your point.
Sahil.
I think... we should learn basic things, and
yes, you should
also understand.
Because
understanding
is basic thing.
Understanding is the main thing. Understanding is the main thing.
Yeah.
If we understand, then we can do everything. We can measure everything, right? Without understanding, right? People are, you know, doing it 7, 8, 10, like okay. So Sahil Mishra, can you hear us? So I think if you can hear us, please turn on your mic. Shail.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So have you spoken on this topic?
No, sir.
Okay, go ahead. Please go ahead. Continue.
According to me, increasing... Actually, voice is coming from that side, so it is disturbing.
Okay, you
please, sir.
According to me, increasing in population nowadays is not good, because due to this, unemployment is taking place as a large scale.
Okay.
And in this specific, in this, both boys as well as male as well as women, both are equally responsible, because girls are forced to bring boy in a family. Due to the uneducation, religious attitude toward the family also, it is.
Yes, that's true.
Yes, legit point.
yes. So, do you want to add anything else in addition to this?
No.
But you have done. Okay, thank you very much. Sanjeev, I think you have spoken. Sanjeev, have you spoken?
Yes, I already have.
Rajib?
I think that the population in China is reduced after the World War II in 1945. Because China focused on the main resource, like food, how to increase food in our country, and it focused on the army.
Okay.
He give every family as a opportunity to came in job as a army.
Okay.
Only 1 and 2 years. Approx. It is necessary to in having in army. So I think that China population is reduced due to the government hard actions, like a population as a member, family member, 2 and 1 children, and each children as work as a nations like army, and it focus on the multinational companies and hub. There are many hub as provided their own captors like Beijing, and multinational companies are making more. Therefore, it increases the GDP. We know that the China condition was not good before the World War.
Yes,
because there is no other companies are as a hub like mobile and others too. So China main focus on the education. Second thing as a food resource and time punctuality. So I think that the China condition as a population is maintaining. And I know that after 10 years, India population is coming as a first after the second China.
Yes, you are right. China shifted their population. Earlier was their main aim is to join the army. So in the same family.
As we know that in China, there is a very less amount of agriculture facilities and land. But they are still growing more than India.
Yes.
Because they are more literate, educated. And they focusing on the punctuality of levels. They came as a proper and out from proper time.
Okay.
Your voice is breaking right now, Raji. But you come up with very good point that now the China focus is the control level, and also they are very punctual while whatever they are doing. Even they have the very less land, but they are cultivating, giving more producer country. And you come up with a very good point. I think it's time to conclude this meeting. And
yes, lovely. Here one member is Marjan. Marjan, can you hear us? Marjan, you have not spoken on the topic increasing population, so would you like to talk on this topic? Marjan, if you are hearing us, yes. So there is a topic, increasing population. Please speak.
Okay, increasing population. Apparently, it doesn't look good. In countries that do not have strong planning and management, they have many problems. They cannot provide resources like education, food, and other things. But when we development countries like Japan or Germany, they need to I think it depended completely to managing our country.
Okay, so you
it's really awesome speech.
Planning management is very important.
Hello?
For reducing. Yeah, Marjan.
Yeah, I believe that.
Thanks. Okay, that's good. Anything you want, AWC? I think you not spoken that topic. I think it's time to conclude that meeting.
Hello, Abhishek. Hello, Abhishek.
Sorry, are
you... Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Please give your views on the topic.
Yes, yes.
What are the reasons behind the increased population day by day, and what are the precautions? What are the measures we can take in to control the virus?
Give your okay, view. I will. My view, actually, this is happening because of lacks of knowledge, actually. Yes, you can say. Well, because yes, in India, if I talk about India especially, yes, now people are more educated than past time, even though they are not that much well educated to understand this kind of things, actually, right? So due to lack of education, proper education, right, due to lack of awareness, they are making this. And like a coin has two sides, in similar way, in this it has two sides. So some good points and some bad points, I will tell you. If I talk about a good point, then yes, population growth provide us like more number of working population, right?
Yes.
And you can say it can be in any office. If you go in any company, if population is there, then more working is there. So economically, GDP will be grow. This is a advantage, you can say.
One minute, Abhishek. I have views in the Australia. There is only only 3 crore population in Australia, but they have a huge resource. So the per capita income is very much high in the Australia. So I think
yes.
if there is a more resource and number of people who consuming it is very less, then it will be more fruitful for their development. In Australia, the HDI index, Human Development Index, is 0.95. It is much higher than other comparing other countries. So the much population is not a indication of the more growth. It's a symbol of actually lack of resources. Yes, sir.
Yes, you are also right, because there are some, you can say, few good things of increasing population, but all are bad. More disadvantages are there than advantages, right? Like it increase in our lots of problems, right? So actually I have not seen about this topic for a long time, and I thought to do a little research, but due to some urgent work I did not able to see. So even though I heard your speech, so I'm talking from your speech, right?
okay, actually I want to conclude on this topic here. I have some points.
Sure,
go ahead.
Actually, the population control we can do by the taking a lots of steps. First, by the government's side, to aware the people, either girls or the boys, so their curriculum or their vice labels, to make them proper aware about the what are the problems with the increasing too much problem. And also the marriage age is also increased up to 19 years. That's a good step taken by the government, but although it is not following the all over the country, so particularly I am talking about the India. So I am generalized to the India, because I think India has more population problem. From the government side, to make the education for the girls and the boys all, and at the if I'm talking about the level of the law and the implementation, the government should make the law for the controlling the population. And from the family side, never give the burden to the couples for the for to make a boy. You are you understand?
Yes, yes. You are totally right. We got your point.
From family side, never forced to the couple for making a boys only. Girls and boys are the equal importance, and not much problem for their heredity also. So from the family, from our society also, from our society, we just prove that. We have to prove that the girls have the equal capability to get a job, to secure their family healthy, wealthy. So the belief system is developed in the society that yes, girls is sufficient for the making a family happy. No need of the much boys only that make their family happy. So this type of the awareness through the people from the individual level, from the society level, from the state level, and from the government level. All make their awareness more truthful and make the country to control the population. Yes. Hello?
Yes, you are audible. You are very much audible.
Yes, I conclude that.
Really, really very good. Very good steps you mentioned here. But yes, this is the main problem. You can, I already told you that each and every wall of the hospital, you can see that you should not plant more than two child, more than two kids. Right. So this is somewhere education is required, and I think government, education system should enlist a topic regarding this, and it should be teach in every educational institution. This will be helpful to some extent, I think. Right. First of all, you can see there are law in Indian constitution. You can see the more than 17 years. One boy should be at least 21 years, right? And one girl should be 18 years, right? Yeah. To get married. Even though you can see in rural area, they are doing marriage below 17, 16 years for 14, 15 years, right? So Indian law is not that much good. They are not following the rules, regulations, right? The corruption is there. So tomorrow topic will be, one topic will be corruption, and another topic you can select and you can suggest us.
Okay, I will suggest because one more topic.
Yes, yes, corruption is there. I can say you, because I can realize this, recently I, seen that one 14 years girl and one, 18 years boy, they got married, right? And police caught them and they give them money and it settled. So this is happening, right? You might be living in a city area, metropolitan city, you might be not aware of these kind of things, but yes, if you realize, if you research on this, then you can get to know that 14 years, 15 years girls are getting married, and 18 years, for 14, 15 years boys are getting married and they have kids, more than 5, 6 kids, so this is not a normality, right?
Yes.
But later on of their life, they regret only. There will be nothing than regret.
I think countries should have a strong rule as like a Sharia or in Saudi Arabia. There is a rule for the, if someone is stole something, then her hand is cut by then sword. Like he never can stole anything.
Yes, the most important thing. See, let me tell you one point.
Very much required.
See, I am saying, I have experienced. I can experience it. The more important thing in Indian education system, there is not that kind of topic. In school colleges, you can see the teacher are not explaining this kind of topics. That is the main reason. Girls are also doing the bad things. Boys are also doing the bad things. Almost. Few girls and few boys are there, they're not doing this kind of things, but yes, so this is lack of education only. I think
there is no quality in the education. They're not properly explained to their generation. they just come.
Explanation should be there. Explanation should be there. Yes, in the class, explanation should be there openly. This is a part of education.
They just conclude their curriculum and just have been finished. There is no
if someone is going,
if they create the curiosity in the brain of the child, then it's much helpful. Because when I was a student, I have so many questions, but they always insult me like that, you are asking very silly question. But later I... realized that I was asking very correct question. Whatever I read, I ask why this happening, what is real importance. So at that time they are thinking this child is very curious and they are wasting not learning important question, which is come on.
Okay, I think conclude that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sure.
Such a good.
So really, we are really pleased to have you here, and we hope we will get together tomorrow also.
Okay.
Right.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye bye all.
Very good night. Very good night.
Thank you, Pooja.
Thank you, Pooja, and thanks all.
Abhishek.
Wish you all the very best.
Thank you all.
Thank you all.
Have a sound sleep and sweet dream.
Okay. Bye, Abhishek.